Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to another exciting edition of Nitro. Good evening, everybody, and welcome back to the VWF Arena. I am Isaac, a.k.a. Omega, as always, here to call the action from the gorilla position. And ladies and gentlemen, what a match we've got slated for you to open out tonight's festivities. There you see Usagi Tsukino in her second week as a former Senshi. And this week, ladies and gentlemen, she's got another match set up. One that was set up by Rei Hino, of course, last week, Usagi's bout with, I believe that was Sakura Haruno, was set up by Rei Hino. And here you see Minako Aino, also known as Sailor Venus. The Senshi all voted unanimously to kick Usagi out of the Senshi. And now, ladies and gentlemen, without her Senshi powers, she's having to work her way back into the good graces of Rei Hino, Makoto Kino, this woman right here, Minako Aino. And ladies and gentlemen, I'm sure Ami Mizuno has an opinion as well. Ladies and gentlemen, what a stacked card we've got coming your way tonight. So stick around. It's going to be great, ladies and gentlemen. What a way to spend your Monday. And ladies and gentlemen, of course, you can always find us on Facebook and Twitter. On Twitter, search for the hashtag VWF Wrestling. Ladies and gentlemen, we are the league that is in touch with you, the fans. So the bell's gone. We are underway, and already just these two starting to feel each other out. Irish whip. Oh my, nice head scissors from Minako Aino. It's Senshi versus former Senshi here tonight, ladies and gentlemen, to start off this week's edition of Nitro. And ladies and gentlemen, I'm sure coming up tonight there will be repercussions. Ladies and gentlemen, who can forget last week when Ami Mizuno went through all three, count them, all three members of Al-Qaeda in a gauntlet match. But ladies and gentlemen, only to be jumped at the conclusion of that contest and to be attacked for the second week in a row with a steel pipe. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm sure if Ami Mizuno is here, she's probably, oh my, as you see a cover there, I'm sure Ami is not a happy camper, ladies and gentlemen. I guess we'll just have to stick around and see if there are any, if there is any fallout from what happened last week. And Usagi Tsukino right now with the advantage. Last week she was able to put away Sakura Haruno, and right now she seems to be well on her way to putting away Minako Aino. The cover, one! And one is all she can get. Oh my, Minako fired face first into the turnbuckle there. Usagi, oh my, nice reversal there by Minako Aino. Minako now perched up on the top row, measures her, and scores with a drop kick. Beautifully executed drop kick right there. One, and only a one. Minako Aino, also known as Sailor Venus. Oh my, tried to go for a splash in the corner, but missed. And oh my, look at that move by Usagi Tsukino. Very unorthodox, but it worked. Ladies and gentlemen, just because, as we saw last week, just because she no longer has her Senshi powers, even though she is no longer Sailor Moon, ladies and gentlemen, Usagi Tsukino is still a great wrestler in there. I mean, you cannot take away the years of experience. And ladies and gentlemen, in that ring, you've got two former NGW Women's Champions. Oh, Minako Aino scores with that crossbody. But I think it may have taken more out of her. Oh, big elbow by Usagi Tsukino. Ladies and gentlemen, also still to come tonight, we've got Hillary Duff in her quote-unquote comeback tour, her making a statement tour, if you will. She will be taking on, as you see, a cover, and only a one. Hillary Duff tonight, ladies and gentlemen, will be taking on Haruka Tenno, one half. of the number one contenders for the tag team titles. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, once again, Haruka and Michiru last week, ladies and gentlemen, were able to once again become the number one contenders. So, ladies and gentlemen, there will be a round four. Oh, my, as you see a huge, devastating Hurricane Rana there into the steel steps. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, there will be a round four between Tequila Sunrise and the Outer Senshi. Right now, Minako Aina with control. No, Usagi fires her into the fan barricade. And a big right hand. And now, oh my, just listen. Oh my goodness. Referee with a 20 count to work with here in the Vixens Wrestling Federation. And look at the hang time on that suplex. Turned it into a face buster. What an opening contest this has been for this week's Nitro. Ladies and gentlemen, as always, we are so glad that you could join us. Usagi now, perched on the top, taking her time, leaps, and nails that unorthodox knee drop there. Lateral press, hook of the leg, one, two. Wow, 2.5, 2.75, maybe. Minako off the ropes. Spinning heel kick by Usagi connects. Ladies and gentlemen, you have to wonder what's going through the minds of the rest of the Senshi. I'm sure they are looking on wherever they may be. And down goes Minako Aino again. Right now, Minako Aino just taking a furious punishment. Usagi is really working out her frustrations on her former Senshi teammate, standing moonsault. And ladies and gentlemen, that move is usually a precursor. Maybe we'll see the moon clash. Maybe Usagi's going to set up the moon clash. She's going for it. Oh, but what a counter by Minako Aino. Oh, my. Minako Aino sniffed that one out and was able to turn it into an X factor. Now Minako with a go behind. Huge kick sends Usagi over the ropes 360. And now Minako, maybe going to take a chance here. Asai moonsault into a martial arts kick. Devastating maneuver. Who wants it more here tonight? Oh, what a suicide dive. Minako Aino throwing caution to the wind. And Usagi Tsukino, she may be out. She may be out. No. Somehow she gets back up to her feet. I have no idea how, ladies and gentlemen. And now Usagi taking a count here. She's got a 20 count to work with. As Minako Aino stares at her from the inside. Now, here comes Usagi. And a little bit of just a stare down here between the two. Oh my! And Minako right there with a flying forearm sends Usagi back to the outside. And Usagi Tsukino right now is in a lot of trouble. Now back into the ring. Go behind on Minako Aino. Minako with a go behind. Into a headlock. Irish whip. Usagi skins the cat back up. Minako misses with a clothesline, but does not miss with that drop kick. Usagi Tsukino once again is right back on the outside. Now Minako's going to give chase. Just powering Usagi up. Usagi might be out on her feet. Oh my. And now Minako, oh, just dropping bombs into the side of Usagi's head. 20,000 plus on hand here tonight, ladies and gentlemen. 20,000 plus, a sold out VWF Arena, excuse me, as always. Ladies and gentlemen, it's one of the hottest tickets in CAW wrestling. Oh my, Usagi there tried to lock up, but Minako counters. Nice drop kick, but Usagi stays on a vertical base. Into an arm bar. Oh, huge elbow. Usagi with a go behind now, but Minaka once again counters it into a headlock. Irish whip, Usagi off the ropes. Missed right there, and Usagi stops her own momentum. Oh, but once again gets tossed face first into the turnbuckle. And now Minaka setting her up on the top. Usagi in a bad place. Neck breaker coming up. Oh, my! And that could do it. That should do it. But Minako Ino's not done. She's back on the top. Scores with a martial arts kick. And now Minako maybe signaling for the V kick. Yes, she's going for it. And caught her right on the chin. And Usagi may be taking a nap. But she kept up. I don't believe it. And Usagi, look at this. Moonclash. She got it. How on earth did she withstand that V-kick? The cover, one, two, and she got her. Ladies and gentlemen, I am impressed. Because Usagi just withstood a V-kick right on the chin, sprung back up, hit the Moonclash, and was able to put Minako Ino away, and there you see. Minako Ino. Maybe now Usagi has someone in her corner as far as the Senshi are concerned. Usagi climbing back up the hard way. And she took a big step here tonight on Nitro. You're taking a look at the replays. What a back and forth contest. And ladies and gentlemen, what a match it was. What a way to start off Nitro. And ladies and gentlemen, now I just wonder, after this impressive victory, if Minako Ino will go back to her fellow Senshi and maybe put in a good word for Usagi. Because this is the second straight victory Usagi has been able to come up with without her Senshi powers. She's got a mic. Let's take you to the ring. And it looks like Rei Hino's going to oblige. And here she comes. Oh my, ladies and gentlemen. And Rei Hino is not kidding. A huge tag team match. Well, ladies and gentlemen, here comes Al Qaeda in the backstage area. Let's take you to the back. Ladies and gentlemen, truly some bombshells for tonight's edition of Nitro. But now, ladies and gentlemen, time for our second contest of the night. Former EWE Siren Champion X23 squares off against former NGW Women's Champion Ashley Simpson. And ladies and gentlemen, as you just heard, a major tag team match set up for next week's edition of VWF Nitro, which is also, ladies and gentlemen, our tribute to the troops the week before Christmas, ladies and gentlemen. And then, of course, for later on tonight, you just saw Abdallah Bin Laden tell her two disciples, Tippa Lockhart and Lindsay, that they are scheduled to face each other in the main event of tonight's Nitro. So a huge main event coming your way in just a few short minutes, ladies and gentlemen. You will definitely not want to miss that, so stick around. And here you see Ashley Simpson in the ring. A lot of bad blood in the last couple of weeks between the Simpson sisters, Ashley and Jessica, against this woman and her unlikely ally, Lara Croft. Ladies and gentlemen, a couple of great tag team matches between these two teams. Most recently with the Simpson sisters coming out on top a couple of weeks ago. And X23, of course, last week, ladies and gentlemen, tried to dig deep into her EWE roots and try and take the hardcore title off of Lufisto, but fell just short in that endeavor. So tonight, ladies and gentlemen, X23 looking to bounce back and make a big statement here. Can she do it against a former women's champion? Oh my, already Ashley tried to throw X23 to the outside. X23, oh my, tried to go for a crossbody but hit the canvas. X23, knee to the midsection, powerbomb, got it. Oh my, did you hear the velocity of which Ashley Simpson landed? One, and only a one. X23, a longtime EWE mainstay with a huge choke slam right there. Another hook of the leg, one. And right now it seems that X23 really wants to put Ashley away quickly. I'm sure X23's probably got to be a little bit disappointed in herself, maybe a little bit frustrated over the last couple of weeks, but ladies and gentlemen, you got to put that behind you because she's in there against a former NGW Women's Champion. Ashley Simpson is no newcomer. Oh, huge kick from the former NGW Women's Champion. And another, this time to the small of the back. Lateral press, one, and only a one. Ashley Simpson, bulldog. With a headlock now. Big elbow over the head of X23. Irish whip, and a crossbody connects. Ashley Simpson, up on the top. Looking to continue her recent wave of momentum. Oh my, nice crossbody. That is in singles competition, of course, ladies and gentlemen, because last week, as you see a cover, and only a one. Last week, Ashley and her sister Jessica fell just a little bit short in a non-title match against Tequila Sunrise. Tequila Sunrise overcame them, but only after a huge comeback. Now X23 takes a leap and nails it. Huge high-risk maneuver. And X23 right now is fighting like a woman possessed. Oh my. Now X23 fires it back to the inside with a forearm over the neck. Oh, and a huge boot to the exposed head of Ashley. And that could do it. The cover, one, two, doesn't hook a leg and doesn't get her. Gotta hook that leg. Big arm drag there. And now X23 just, you can almost see the frustration in the eyes and in the demeanor of X23. X23 usually had her way in the women's ranks in EWE. But ladies and gentlemen, the Vixens Wrestling Federation is a whole different ballgame. X-23 was usually used to being the tougher woman, being the last woman to make the mistake, to try and use her healing factor to her advantage. And in EWE, it really paid off. That's why she was a former Siren champion. But here, ladies and gentlemen, it's a little bit more about finesse. And I think X-23's just had a tough time adapting. And look at the power on that gut buster there. And X-23 right now is really looking good. Ashley's in a lot of trouble here. Fired into the turnbuckle. X-23 giving chase. Nails that shoulder dive right there. And look at her just pick up Ashley by her hair. X-23 is really on the warpath here tonight. But oh, that left her wide open for a bulldog. Ashley Simpson right now has to look to counter off of some of these moves that X-23 is throwing at her. X-23 is really not doing a good job. She's kind of being sloppy in there, letting her emotions guide her. And ladies and gentlemen, that's a good way to walk into a mistake and lose the match in a hurry. X-23 really needs to calm down. Oh, misses with that leg drop. That, once again, not a well-calculated risk. Another elbow by Ashley. And Ashley Simpson right now just seems content to work off of X-23's mistakes, but X-23 right there nailed a clothesline, and Ashley now is on the outside, and she's not showing much signs of life. X-23 celebrating in the ring. Really feeling it right now. Oh, but Ashley right there taunted her. Oh, my. And led her right into a huge mistake. And X-23, if she would just try and keep a level head in there, try and use her experience, but oh my! X-23's skull just dropped right on that unforgiving concrete. If X-23 would just use her experience and maybe slow this match down, she would have had it won by now. But instead, she keeps just trying to punish Ashley Simpson, and Ashley is working off those mistakes. X-23, oh my, another move right there that she didn't think out. And once again, Ashley Simpson takes advantage. Ashley on the top. Scores with that senton splash. Listen to these fans trying to get behind X-23, but oh, as you see a huge side effect there. The Simpson effect, if you will. And X-23 is wide open. Ashley to the top. Lip sync assault coming up. Got it. Hook of the leg. The cover. The count. No. X-23 kicked out. Unbelievable. Some of the toughness we're seeing here tonight. In our opening match, we saw Usagi kick out of a V-kick. No, jump up out of a V-kick. And now we're seeing X-23 hitting her second wind after some of Ashley Simpson's best moves. X-23 using that healing factor. And Ashley misses with the clothesline. Peacekeeper, got it. And that could have just turned the lights out on the former women's champion. One, two, forget about it. X-23 overcomes a sloppy match, overcomes a lot of mistakes, overcomes a lot of punishment. And ladies and gentlemen, she finds a way to dig deep into that EWE never say die spirit. And tonight, ladies and gentlemen, she is your winner in singles competition over her heated rival, Ashley Simpson. Huge victory for X-23. And ladies and gentlemen, that may right the ship for the former EWE Siren champion here in the Vixens Wrestling Federation. Big win for X-23. And well, ladies and gentlemen, almost right on cue, we're taking you to the back now, and now it's Jill Valentine this time that's trying her luck with the super hardcore anime Lufisto, trying to take that hardcore title off of her waist. You ever notice how we never have anybody back in the backstage area to break up this, or at least try, or... Oh, well. Lufisto, of course, was jumped last week by X-23, and Lufisto was somehow able to retain the hardcore title as you see a devastating powerbomb. Having that hardcore title here in the Vixens Wrestling Federation makes you a marked woman. That is for sure. And Jill right there with a drop kick. And now she's got the barbells. That's probably about 100 pounds of weight. Oh my, but Lufisto with a couple of rakes of the back. That's as legal as any kind of move that you can imagine. And right now, both of these women using that weight bench. And Jill's got the barbells again. Oh, my. Oh, and just absolutely threw them on Lufisto. Lufisto's lucky that didn't crush her windpipe. Like I said, it's all about being the hardcore champion here in the Vixens Wrestling Federation. But what a champion, what a hardcore champion that Lufisto has been. She has been ready 24/7, 365, ladies and gentlemen, for any kind of a challenge. When you become the hardcore champion, you have to know what you're getting yourself into. And Lufisto has done just that. And Jill Valentine may be biting off a little bit more than she can chew here. Because Lufisto was just easily taking care of Jill. Oh, my. That's some face-first action right there. And Lufisto now. Oh, my, with another powerbomb. And that's it. Lufisto retains the hardcore title once again, ladies and gentlemen. A true fighting champion. All right, ladies and gentlemen, a match I spoke of earlier in the night. Hillary Duff still looking to make a statement here in the Vixens Wrestling Federation. Squares off against one half of the number one contenders for the tag team titles. Ladies and gentlemen, Haruka Tenno is her opponent here tonight. And here comes Haruka. And interestingly enough, Michiru is nowhere to be found. Haruka Tenno looking to come out here and overcome Hillary Duff by herself, maybe. Of course, ladies and gentlemen, it was last week, ladies and gentlemen, on Nitro that Haruka, along with her tag team partner as well as life partner, Michiru Kaio, defeated Team G4 to earn the number one contendership for the VWF tag titles. Once again, ladies and gentlemen, it will be round four between the Outer Senshi and Tequila Sunrise. Will the fourth time be the charm for Haruka and Michiru? And listen to this crowd, ladies and gentlemen, because here comes the former CCW Women's Champion, the former ROW Intercontinental Champion, and the former ROW World Heavyweight Champion. Because here comes Hillary Duff. Ladies and gentlemen, she's been on a make-a-statement tour, if you will, the last couple of weeks, ladies and gentlemen. Most recently, 2 weeks ago, Hillary Duff put away Mickie James. Hillary, of course, trying to catch the attention of the VWF Championship Committee, maybe. Perhaps line herself up for a title shot. And ladies and gentlemen, so far, she's really been impressive over all of the competition she's taken care of. I mean, you can remember a couple of weeks ago, she took out Renoa Hartelli. And then 2 weeks ago, she took care of former hardcore champion Mickie James. And ladies and gentlemen, she looks to add Haruka to that list of victims here tonight. And you have to imagine, ladies and gentlemen, Hillary Duff has really got to be close to earning perhaps a VWF title shot. Colonel Bataya. These two women right now just getting a feel for one another. You have to imagine, of course, ladies and gentlemen, that Tequila Sunrise, the VWF Tag Team Champions, Dixie Clements and Reiko Hinamoto have to really be looking on with interest at this one. It'll be interesting to see how Haruka fares in singles competition without her lesbian partner, Michiru. Maybe Haruka looking to send a message, perhaps. Trying to say that maybe the Outer Senshi are trying to send a message here, ladies and gentlemen, that they don't have to cut corners to overcome their opposition. And right now it's all Hillary Duff. Hillary Duff looking to, as I said a moment ago, add another name to her already long list of victims on her statement tour. And ladies and gentlemen, Hillary Duff has to be close. You have to imagine, with a victory here tonight, she would have to be just inches away from maybe a VWF championship shot. And right there, a big choke slam there from Haruka. And Haruka, oh my, just slamming Hillary Duff's head into the canvas. Hillary Duff has no way to cover up. And that'll even the odds in a hurry. Of course, ladies and gentlemen, still to come tonight, the main event of the evening, as you see a cover, only a one. Still to come, the main event of the evening, number one contendership for the VWF title on the line tonight as two members of Al-Qaeda explode here tonight, ladies and gentlemen. Tipa Lockhart takes on Lindsay. The two disciples of Abdallah bin Laden clash here tonight in the main event. And, oh my, Haruka continues to go to work on Hillary Duff. And look at the deceptive power. Haruka just lifting up Hillary Duff with ease. And right now, Hillary Duff is really not in this. The last 5 minutes or so, it's been all Haruka. And you have to imagine, that's definitely causing Dixie Clements and Reiko Hinamoto to really pay attention here. The cover, one, two, only a two. And Hillary Duff right now really not, oh my, as you see her just, that was desperation, and so was that, but it connects. A big crossbody block to the outside. And Hillary Duff has just turned the tides in this match in an instant. Now Hillary Duff trying to get back in this one. Fires Haruka into the corner. And Hillary Duff off the ropes. Bulldog. Hillary Duff, of course, will be looking to hit that trademark unprettier. But only a one count. We've still got a long way to go, I'm sure. Drop kick from Hillary Duff finally sends Haruka down. And Hillary Duff going for a power bomb. Yes. Devastating maneuver there. And that could do it. One, two, no. And right back into the corner and right back in trouble goes Haruka. Hillary Duff chopping away now. Setting her up on the top maybe. Superplex City coming up. Got it. And that may have just won the match. One, two, oh my, referee saying two only. That was very, very close, ladies and gentlemen. And Hillary Duff almost overcame Haruka and could have just earned herself a number one contendership spot, but ladies and gentlemen, the match continues. Now Haruka with a couple of moves and firing Hillary Duff into the turnbuckle and a huge shoulder charge. And now stomping away on Hillary Duff. This one's really been back and forth. Ladies and gentlemen, I gotta say, I'm kind of surprised. When I saw this match on the card, before we went on the air, ladies and gentlemen, I thought that maybe Haruka come in, and maybe the momentum off of earning the number one contendership to the tag titles might have kept her in this match for a while, but ladies and gentlemen, I was looking for Hillary Duff to just slowly assert her will, but it's just never happened. Haruka is looking really impressive here tonight, even without Michiru in her corner. Oh, Hillary Duff tried to go for a lion salt, and she missed. Well, she didn't miss completely. She took out the referee. And another huge shove into the canvas by Haruka. And now Haruka, oh no, going. Oh no, she's got a chair in there. Come on, referee. Give me a break here. You have to imagine if Haruka uses that chair, it'll be instant disqualification. And there you see once again another military press. And thankfully it looks like the official has gotten the chair out of there. But that doesn't stop Haruka from continuing to go to work here. A big suplex, and now Haruka may be signaling for the ground shaking. Yes, she's setting her up. Here it comes. Here it comes, ladies and gentlemen. The ground's shaking. Hillary Duff is not moving at all. This could be it. The cover. 1, 2. And a very impressive victory on the part of Haruka Tenno here tonight. And ladies and gentlemen, the Hillary Duff Express just ran into a huge roadblock. The Hillary Duff Express, ladies and gentlemen, has completely derailed off the tracks here tonight. Haruka made it look easy against the former CCW Women's Champion. And ladies and gentlemen, that's got to send a huge message to the tag team champions, Tequila Sunrise. Because ladies and gentlemen, Michiru wasn't even at ringside. Michiru was not here to even be a factor. Haruka beat Hillary Duff fair and square. And here comes Michiru. I wonder what's going to happen here. Ladies and gentlemen, a TLC match for the tag team titles at Femme Fatale. Ladies and gentlemen, let's take you to the CEO, Frederick James Francis. And ladies and gentlemen, the boss lays down the law. Ladies and gentlemen, it's main event time for this week's edition of Nitro. This is for number one contendership for the VWF Championship. Al-Qaeda explodes as Lindsay takes on Tipa Lockhart. The two disciples of Abdallah bin Laden go head-to-head here tonight on Nitro. And keep in mind, ladies and gentlemen, that if either Tipa or Lindsay try to take a dive, that, ladies and gentlemen, Al-Qaeda will be suspended. Diana Buffer, take it away. Definitely some animosity the last couple of weeks between the two disciples of Abdallah bin Laden. Lindsay has kind of felt perhaps like the outcast of Al-Qaeda, maybe the black sheep of the group. And tonight, Lindsay perhaps will be looking to take out some of that frustration on who she perceives to be Abdallah's favorite of the two. Lindsay, of course, a former NGW Women's Champion. Lindsay joined Al-Qaeda on the very first episode of Nitro because Frederick James Francis would not offer her a contract into the Vixens Wrestling Federation. Abdallah bin Laden was able to exploit a loophole, if you will. And she is the entire reason that Lindsay is here in the first place. Lindsay has come a long way since she aligned herself with the mysterious Abdallah bin Laden all those months ago. And tonight, ladies and gentlemen, she looks to climb back to the top of the mountain. She looks to become, once again, the number one contender for the VWF title. Her last title shot was at Retribution. She was defeated by Aerith Gainsborough. And here comes Tipa Lockhart, also a former NGW Women's Champion, as well as a former NGW Women's Tag Team Champion. And ladies and gentlemen, she's kind of maybe been the apple of Abdallah bin Laden's eye, if you will, for the last couple of weeks. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm not sure. You have to wonder what Abdallah bin Laden said to these two before they went out here tonight. What could the leader of Al-Qaeda have possibly said to her two disciples before they were set to square off for a chance at the number one prize in the company? What do you say? Definitely some retaliation here by the CEO, Frederick James Francis, trying to put Al-Qaeda into some trouble, perhaps. And the bell's gone. We are underway. This is your main event here tonight on Nitro. And who will become the number one contender? That is the question we are here to answer. Of course, ladies and gentlemen, Frederick James Francis said if there is a finger poke of doom here tonight, ladies and gentlemen, if one of these two takes a dive for the other, then all three members of Al-Qaeda would be suspended for half of a year. So, ladies and gentlemen, these two have to go at it. Tipa and Lindsay definitely have to go at it here tonight. There is no backing down out of this. And right now, I think these two perhaps are relishing the opportunity to take out some frustration on one another. There's definitely been some friction between these two in the ranks of Al-Qaeda. And you have to imagine that this is ladies and gentlemen, I hate to say this, but maybe this is actually a good opportunity for Al-Qaeda to flesh itself out here, if you're looking at it through Al-Qaeda's eyes. Definitely a lot of talking going on in that squared circle. Karnabo tie-up. Headlock by Tifa. Missed with the European uppercut. Forearm from Lindsay connects. Irish whip. Tifa off the ropes. Lindsay tried to go for a shoulder tackle, but a nice little duck under there and a nice uppercut by Tifa Lockhart. These two are no strangers to each other as opponents, if you will, ladies and gentlemen. These two faced each other quite a bit in New Gen Wrestling. And a big suplex there by Lindsay. Lindsay now with a lateral press. One. And one is all she can get. Lindsay and Tifa. This is for the number one contendership to the VWF Championship. But ladies and gentlemen, who knows who they'll be facing once they cash that number one contendership in. There's no guarantee that Aerith Gainsborough will be back, ladies and gentlemen. She has one more week. Of course, ladies and gentlemen, next week is the Vixens Wrestling Federation's tribute to the troops. And of course, ladies and gentlemen, it'll be put up or shut up time for Aerith Gainsborough next week. She has to show up with a clean bill of health next week, ladies and gentlemen, or she forfeits the VWF Championship. And ladies and gentlemen, what a shame it would be for the Vixens Wrestling Federation's first ever champion to have to forfeit the belt. I know that Aerith doesn't want that, and I know, ladies and gentlemen, that you, the fans, definitely don't want that. And a nice takedown there from Lindsay. Lindsay now with the advantage, using the ropes for leverage, and still only could get a one. Even when she tried to use the ropes for leverage, it was only a one count. Oh my, Tifa walked into a drop toe hold there. Definitely two seasoned veterans going at it here tonight in the main event. Say what you will about Tifa Lockhart and Lindsay, but ladies and gentlemen, you can't take away that they are very skilled wrestlers. Definitely two of the best in women's CAW wrestling. Now Tifa, Irish whip, Lindsay off the ropes, leapfrog from Tifa, and go behind, beautiful German suplex. Oh my. And Lindsay is all flustered, taking a walk on the outside. And right now, Lindsay and Tifa talking a little bit. As Lindsay continues to pace the outside. And now Lindsay back on the apron. And look at this. Tifa turns her back on her. Tifa turns her back on her, trying to get into the head of Lindsay. You have to wonder if the mind games are taking their toll on Lindsay. Tifa now. Oh, my, huge knee to the midsection right there. Some lefts and rights, and over the ropes, 360 goes Lindsay. Lindsay right back on the outside. And Tifa feeling really good at this point. Well, ladies and gentlemen, in this commentator's opinion, I wouldn't mind if this went to a double countout or to some sort of draw. But of course, ladies and gentlemen, for what it's worth, either one of these two would be deserving of the number one contendership. Either one of these two could very well become the next VWF champion. Oh my, and just Tifa Lockhart stomping the life out of Lindsay. Lindsay's really taking a beating in there right now. Tifa throws her once again back into the turnbuckle. Oh my, but a spear missed. Lindsay sidestepped her there. Oh my, and she comes crashing right back down to earth. Lindsay looking to hit the FUB. But Tifa looking to hit the final heaven. Oh, thumb to the eye there from Tifa Lockhart. And another one of those well-executed German suplexes. And Tifa Lockhart right now, not really in any hurry to give chase to Lindsay. And that definitely has to be getting under Lindsay's skin. Lindsay must be wondering if Tifa's taking her lightly. And Tifa continues going to work on Lindsay. Oh my, just listen to those strikes, ladies and gentlemen. Some devastating blows. But Lindsay with a Russian leg sweep. Lindsay trying to get the advantage back. DDT. Shades of Jake the Snake Roberts on that one. Could it be enough? One, two, and only a two. Lindsay sends Tifa back into the turnbuckle. And a shoulder charge connects. As well, oh my, as a knee charge there. And now Lindsay driving the elbow. And we've got an arm bar here. Lindsay perhaps setting up for the STFUB. And another flying tackle. What a main event here tonight, ladies and gentlemen, between the two disciples of Abdallah. And only a one count there. What's Lindsay, what does Lindsay have to do to put away Tifa here? Oh my, that will definitely help. Clothesline sends Tifa to the outside. Now it's Tifa on the outside for a change. Lindsay quick to give chase. Oh my, just fires Tifa Lockhart into those unforgiving steel steps. And, oh my, definitely a career-shortening move as Lindsay just suplexed Tifa Lockhart into the remaining portion of the steel steps. Oh my, that could have definitely paralyzed Tifa Lockhart, that is for sure. But Tifa back with a clothesline. And now, oh my, Tifa lifts up Lindsay and drops her onto that steel barricade. Oh, but Lindsay right back with a Russian leg sweep on that concrete floor. Once again, you have to wonder what is going through the mind of Abdallah bin Laden watching her two disciples just absolutely punish one another. And now, Lindsay going for the cover. Feet on the ropes, and not even a count. Not even a count, ladies and gentlemen. And Tifa Lockhart may have found her second wind here. And once again, she's stomping the life out of Lindsay. Lindsay is not bouncing up like Tifa did. Now in the corner. Oh, it's just a decapitating clothesline. And maybe, ladies and gentlemen, maybe Lindsay has run out of gas here. Big spine buster, shades of Arn Anderson. Lateral press. No hook of the leg. Tifa, though, continues to go to work on her Al-Qaeda teammate. Tifa can put this one away at any time. Lindsay is out on her feet. Choke slam coming up. Lifts her up and down to the canvas. Lindsay shows no signs of life. And here it comes, ladies and gentlemen. Final heaven. Got it. Tifa Lockhart, maybe just one number one contendership. One, two, yes. And Tifa Lockhart has defeated her comrade Lindsay. And Tifa is the new number one contender for the VWF title. What a match, ladies and gentlemen. What a back and forth match between the two Al-Qaeda members. But in the end, Tifa Lockhart found her second win and was able to hit the final heaven on Lindsay. Makes the cover and becomes the new number one contender. Wait a minute, ladies and gentlemen. Wait a minute. That's Ami. And Ami and Tifa are going at it, ladies and gentlemen. Ami definitely retaliating for last week's attack. And these two going at it on the ramp. Fighting their way to the back. Ladies and gentlemen, these two women were once the best of friends. Now, they are the worst of enemies. Oh, no. Oh, no. Oh, my God. On the edge of the ramp. Oh, my God. That's a 15-foot fall. Oh, my God, ladies and gentlemen. Oh, my God.